All right, what is going on, my lovely individuals of the world? We're here today with some Guilty Gear. It's going to take me a little bit of time to get to a match-ready point, but, you know, I've done a fair amount of stuff now. I've at least looked at everything available, and so I feel like I've formulated a proper opinion and I can talk about stuff. So, firstly and foremostly, which character? I'm pretty sure I'm heading for Jacko. I'm a little wary of her in general because she seems really simplistic. I don't know if this is true, whether or not this is going to carry over to like actual matches played with her, but she just feels like she doesn't really have much going for her. And she doesn't really have much to do. Whereas like, so for instance, I look at a character like Chip. Who at least I'm not having played a ton of matches with him, but I at least know his moveset, I know his capabilities. That dude is capable of everything. Like, you can basically do whatever the fuck you want, whenever you want to, if you can execute it. He's an amazing character, and like, everything I would look for in a fighting game, if only he wasn't made of now granted if he was not made of just the flimsiest type of paper ever, he would be overpowered as fuck. Like, could you imagine a character like Chip with Potemkin health? Good god. But and so he should be that fragile, but you just combine the fact with like, it's so difficult at every single moment in time to play perfectly with Chip, and it's too stressful for me. I'm not looking to try and play as seriously as possible every time I sit down and play the game, and that's kind of how I feel you have to play Chip in order to succeed with him, and I'm just not looking for that. But aside from that one factor, like, Chip is the perfect character for me. Then you look at somebody like Jacko, who I do think is a very effective character. I think she's kind of middle of the road. I don't know how she's actually, how Japan regards her, how kind of people in general regard her, but in terms of just kind of what I can see personally, I think she's a fairly average character. She's not really bad, she's just not really good either. But my main concern is, again, that I feel like she's fairly limited in terms of what she's capable of and what I can do at any given moment, to the point where it might become somewhat flowcharty by necessity, because there's just nothing else to really do. It's just, I can do this, and that's really it. So we'll see how it goes. I mean, in the short little clip that I showed of Raven, which I'll talk about in a second, a couple people did ask me, like, hey man, what character are you gonna use? And I replied that I was gonna use Jacko, that I was looking at either Sin or Jacko, and a couple people on top of that were like, oh sick man, I hope you pick Jacko, and nobody said anything about Sin, so fuck it, I guess I'm gonna try out Jacko. That being said, I don't think there's much Jacko representation in general. Like, I don't think she really caught on in Japan, and she doesn't really have a lot of people playing her. Whereas, two of the best Guilty Gear players, period, have picked up Sin. And that is Dogura and Machabu? I'm not entirely sure how you're supposed to pronounce his name. But seeing his name quite a bit when I was paying attention to Exard's sign, and he was a godlike soul. He used a little bit of Kai as well, but I distinctly remember his soul and how incredibly good he was. And so he popped up a little while back before Revelator dropped on consoles. I remember seeing like 4 videos posted on Golden Roadie's channel, who I think, more or less, I would say he's kind of like the Jordal of Guilty Gear. They like 4 videos or so of just him playing Sin, and I saved them to watch later when like I actually sat down and learned Sin and understood, you know, every single move, so I can understand what I'm seeing in neutral, what I'm seeing in combos, understand and process it rather than just watching it and being like, oh, that looks cool. And I never really got around to it because I never got around to learning Sin. But now that I've actually sat down and I have done the majority of characters' combo stuff. Again, I'll get into all the nitty-gritty of this stuff in a moment. But like, I've done most characters. Like, you see, it's on Jam. I just went through. I started at the top left and I just went through everybody's stuff. And so I went through everybody as far as like, what was it that was fucking me up here? I think it was just, oh, no, I wasn't fucking anything up with this. I was just, because I was just casually going through And I was like, you know what? Sin's a character that I actually want to learn. I don't want to just kind of casually browse through his advanced combos. But, like, for instance, I think I did all Kai's? Yeah, Kai's are mad easy. If you're looking for somebody to just finish it with, Kai's were incredibly easy. But then I think Mei was the character I didn't even finish. Yeah, I didn't even finish hers because this one... Yeah, required a standing move into a crouching move into a charge, and I just saw that and I was like, I don't know how tight the timing is, but fuck it, I don't like charge moves. But most characters, I went all the way through and I did all their special attacks, all their special attacks, all of their basic combos, and then basically I hit advanced and I went as far into advanced as I could go before hitting a point where I got to one that I could not finish in my first 5 tries. So doing that, I learned a lot about the basics of each character, what their moves looked like, and so after that, I started watching some Guilty Gear videos, and one of those featured the aforementioned Makabu. This motherfucker. So, when you're looking at the best players in general, in the arcades, games like BlazBlue and Guilty Gear, they show a little fight card beforehand. Like, I mean, it's the same kind of thing. I think I can look at it from here? Yeah, so we just look at my, I'm Emperor Edgelord. So it's just, it's something that looks similar to this, gives you a little bit of introductory information, and it displays the amount of matches you've played and the amount of matches you've won. Now, when you're looking at the best players in Japan, or the best players in general, you'll see they tend to have around a 70% to 75% win record. Very high, very solid, very good. That is generally denotes that they're a very solid player. Like, it either denotes that they're a very, very good player, or that they are punching far below their weight class. Like, one of the two. I've seen some players with, like, ridiculous records who run into, you know, like, the actual high-tier players, and they just get destroyed because they're used to just fighting lesser competition. But so, anyway, like I said, generally the highest-tier people are kind of around the 70 to 75% win rate. And, like, the best of them, people like Fenrich and BlazBlue, who are, like, always the highest-ranked people on the leaderboards, will have, like, an 80% win rate. So, the video plays. Oh, it's Makabu. Oh, he's using Sin. Sick, I can watch this and actually understand something now. So he picks his character. Opponent picks his character. His card pops up. This motherfucker has 1,064 games played. Matches played. And he's not sitting at, like, you know, 750 wins, 800 wins, 900 wins. He is sitting on 1,004 wins. This dude has lost around 5% of his matches. That is ridiculous. Ridiculous. And then he got blown up by Nakamura's. Was it Nakamura? He got blown up by Amelia, somebody's Milia, which of course, I mean, that's probably where every single one of his 60 losses came from, was either Elfelt or Milia, those bullshit characters. But it was kind of funny, it was like, oh man, he just, like, he steamrolled the first two people, and then he got Milia, and I was like, oh cool, there's another loss to add to his record, that's gotta feel bad. But just seeing that, 1,004 wins, 60 losses, what the fuck, I guess 1,006 wins now and 65 losses? But still, what the fuck? That is ridiculous. So yeah, like, even if I did pick up Sin, I'm never gonna get to that level. Like, I think I could, if America is at a point that I legitimately feel like anybody who is dedicated enough has the ability, the opportunity to be a high level anime game player. But then you put, then you add Japan into the equation, and, like, you know how a lot of times you'll, in regard to anything competitive, you will hear the term, he's a big fish in a small pond, basically saying that, sure, you're a very good player, but only against your local competition that isn't very good overall. You are only good in comparison to them. Come play in the big boy pool, and we'll show you how people really work. The way I see America in competition with Japan, we're not in a pond. We're not in a kiddie pool. We are still toddlers playing with our baby ducklings. With our little yellow duckies that we squeeze and make squeaky noises with in the bathtub. And Japan is just out there fucking wandering the wilds of the ocean. Great white sharks roaming around. Tiger sharks going nuts. And we're just still sitting there splashing around in the bathtub. So, anyway, whatever. I'm not here to discuss that whole thing. So, Guilty Gear specifically. Now, actually, let me just go straight to the lobbies. I'm actually curious how it is about 2 p.m. for me, Pacific Standard Time. And I would like to see just how populated. That's actually not much more populated than I've seen it in general. So, but now I would like to see the connection. So you have these. So, again. Not again. But these lobbies vastly improved upon whatever the fuck signs were. Like, these are wonderful. They have little arcade machines you can sit around. So it's similar to, like, the... It's actually mostly similar to the Persona 4 Arena lobbies. But then even beyond that, you can then from here join either search for a ranked match, or you can search for a player match, or you can fish. Look at my money. See? I've been putting in work. I got money out the asshole. So one of the comments on my prior video in regard to my opinion that Guilty Gear Revelator was not worth the $60 price tag. It should not have been a full price game. I am still of that opinion. But one of the counterpoints to that that somebody raised was, hey man, look, they improved lobbies. They improved, there's a all new training and mission mode that's, you know, very, very good. And those, both of those things I agree with. These lobbies are vastly improved. They actually look good and I like them. But then they also mentioned fishing on top of that. And like, this isn't even gameplay. This is the prototypical freemium unlock of stuff that is available thing. I am basically going to a shop and purchasing a gift box that I then open and get an assorted group of items that are available. There's nothing gameplay associated with this. There's nothing, like, I don't know why you would raise fishing as a point for, like, hey man, this game has that. So it totally deserves a higher price tag and stuff. That confused me. But I do 100% agree with you that the lobbies are vastly improved. I'm hoping I can find a player match that is not a Japanese room, because that's all I found. I have found 99% Japanese rooms. And, oh, okay, good. This is a lot better. Look at those three-bar connections, baby! All I found before this is pure, nope, I don't want to join the one with only one. All I found prior to this are Twitch, oh, you see right there, Twitch streaming. I found those types of rooms. This is awesome. I fucking love this. I love this. I legitimately love this. It's awesome. So I'm gonna go ahead and leave now so nobody notices me and is like, hey, let's play a match. God damn! Does everybody, oh no, those are all just the player match people. Okay. I thought those were all people, like, just because all this stuff, this player match stuff, was kind of obscuring my vision. I thought all these people were on these little machines. So yeah, so anyway, I mean, I love, oh, that's fucking, it shows their life bars? That's kind of cool. I dig that. Is there any way to, like, spectate this? I don't want to open up the menu, but if you send message, no. Nothing like spectation. Oh, you can dash? Yo, look at, if only fighting games used buttons for dashing instead of Marvel. Marvel's my shit. I could dash in Marvel consistently because it used buttons. Damn, I really wish. Let me open up a menu and let me see. Is there any way to, like, no. I was really hoping there might be a way to spectate these. Maybe you can, like, let me hop up to, like, a new one? I don't want to wait for the opponent. But can I, like, L1 shortcuts? Oh. The fuck is this? Bow. This is some MMA. Yes! I got a trophy! Oh, I was hoping there might be a sound. Nod. That's adorable. Yeah, I was hoping there might be a way to spectate that stuff. But anyway, like I said, this vastly improved upon whatever the fuck lobbies were in Sign. If they maintain it like this, which I hope they do, they're looking good. Mission mode. So, I'm gonna nitpick for a little bit. So, tutorial mode is just basic. Look at my time right there. That's fucking amazing. They make you play as Soul for all of these. And that's where my nitpicking comes in. I really wish that fighting game... So, fighting game tutorials in general, things like this, generally only allow you to utilize one character for them. And it generally tends to be that main character. So, for Street Fighter, it would be Ryu. For this, it's Soul. For BlazBlue, it would be Ragna. For King of Fighters, it would be Terry. That kind of thing. So, like, they kind of shoehorn in the main character. And I really wish they wouldn't, because there are going to be a lot of people who are coming in who aren't interested in just the main character. And so, like, for instance, for me, this is okay. This takes no time whatsoever. But this whole thing, now, these don't force you to use Soul in them, as you can see. I got, which one? I think I got to, like, the reversal one where you, oh, no, is that the one? Yeah, so what's this one? The Bane of Meaty attacks. Time to, oh, the Meaty, okay, I didn't even try that one. This one has fucking ridiculous, let me actually just show you. This one has ridiculous timing necessary. Like, it's gotta be very, oh, you, this time, look at your, uh-oh. Oh. Damn it. I'm trying, oh, damn, I did it! Damn. Damn. Counter? Oh, I didn't even try that time. But yeah, the timing on that shit is crazy. Fucking crazy. What? Bitch. Oh, that was way too fucking early. Anyway, I'm not gonna sit here and continue doing that. But the majority of these utilize Soul. Some of them use Kai. There was one that I think used Leo. I wanted. There was one charge move mission, and that one obviously can't use Soul or Kai, so it used Leo instead. I don't know if there are any other different ones in here that utilize a different character other than Soul or Kai, but almost all of them that I have seen have used Soul or Kai. So again, just this. Oh, I don't want to go to the main menu. Just the simple fact that they shoehorn in those characters and don't tailor it to everybody in the cast makes me a little sad, because I would be far more interested in doing sitting down and actually doing all of these. Eventually, I am going to sit down and do all of these, because I think it would be useful, obviously. But I would be more interested and invested in it if I was given the ability to utilize a character I actually care about. That being said, you have this. I didn't notice you could go back and forth. I think I just accidentally landed on this. I was like, wait, what is this? Oh, shit. And then I came over here. And then I came to this menu. This ugly-ass menu. So it starts here. Now. I saw this. I saw select the character you wish to use. And I got mad excited. I was like, holy shit. They're actually doing this thing that I want. You go, Guilty Gear. And then I kind of noticed, why is Soul the only one listed? Why is there nobody else? Because I'm kind of sitting here thinking, oh, that's probably supposed to be a drop-down menu of some sort or something. It's not. That bar underneath it has a yellow slider on a yellow background that you're somehow just supposed to fucking notice. That's a fucking ugly ass menu, man. It's already all orange and yellow and bright red. Like, come the fuck on, man. Who picked these colors? And at least make the slider a different color so it actually draws attention to itself rather than just being there and kind of, you know, like actually having to focus and stare at it to notice, oh wait, there's actually something there. Let me check shit out. That being said, this is awesome. I really hope, because right now there's only two. This is for matchup specific stuff. So for instance, right here, I think, is this the one that, I believe this one wants you to block and punish Soul's DP, and you're supposed to do, I don't know move names, but I believe this is you're supposed to block and punish Soul's DP, and you need to do 100 damage, I want to say. Yeah, I don't know any Jacko combo, so I'm not about to be able to do that. But so that's absolutely fantastic, but it made me, I really hope they expand upon that further in future iterations of the game, and so they have more than just two little things for every single character, because that's basically how you properly learn matchups. That's setting up how you properly learn matchups. If you want to learn stuff that you're having trouble with, you go into training mode, you use the AI record feature that hopefully fighting games should implement from now on, to make the AI control, not the AI control, but make the second player do something, whatever you're having trouble with, and then you either try to block it, interrupt it, you figure out ways to beat it. That's the best way to learn a matchup. That's the best way to figure out how to deal with things you're having problems with. And that's exactly what this is. It's setting up common situations that people potentially struggle with in regard to fighting different characters, and then sets you up and says, do this, figure it out. And so I really appreciate that. I really like that. And again, I think this tutorial at the very least, and at least some kind of combo kind of thing, is necessary for any future fighting game going forward. Everybody should try to implement something like this. This is above and beyond the necessary tutorial stuff. I think it would be nice if everybody implemented something like this, but I don't think it's a necessity. It's very close, but I wouldn't like hate on any game for not having something like this. But that, like I said, the nitpicking comes in by saying that I really wish that they would implement the ability to use whatever character you want. But the reason why I consider that nitpicking is because that's a lot of effort to tailor stuff around a character. So for instance, all that, this stuff with Soul, this is tailored to Soul's movement. And so when you start this up, they throw out little balloons around the arena that you need to hit using the various forms of movement in the game. In order to actually hit them. So this, you just dash forward, back dash, etc., that kind of stuff. So you have Soul's movement abilities, utilizing those properly. Not everybody has the same movement, not everybody has the same jump arcs. Chip, for instance, obviously gets 3 aerial movements instead of the majority of the rest of the cast getting 2. Potemkin doesn't get any air dash whatsoever. So you're going to have to tailor each of these individually to each characters, and that is a lot of additional effort to put in for something that doesn't have a massive return to it. Like, again, it's something that would be nice, but in terms of, you know, like the effort versus the reward for actually doing that, not really equivalent. Thus, I'm not like disappointed in the game for not putting that in. Did I have anything else? I don't think I really had anything else. Story mode. Can we talk about biking for a second? I didn't pay attention to the story mode. I didn't watch it. I just let it run because it will autoplay the entire way through. You can just sit here. You can just start it up. It'll autoplay the entire way through. Okay, between each chapter, you have to decide whether or not you want to continue without saving or save first and then continue. But that's all the input necessary on your end, so like I just let it play. But I would glance over occasionally while I was doing other stuff, and biking popped up. And let me tell you, I can dig it a little bit. I might like me some biking. That's the other thing. Combos. Just, you know, maintaining the same frame of thought, the same thought process and whatnot. Unfortunately, I don't much care for Jacko's colors. Like, you see, I'm just on her default. That one's alright. The big thing, though, is that your color choice with Jacko actually changes the color. I think it changes the color of her minions. And it also changes the color of the little fire effect around her dust moves and her super moves. So that's kind of cool, but in terms of like her actual colors, I don't much care for them. But I'm gonna try this just so I can kind of see what stuff looks like. I'm not here to check that out. I don't care about any of that. I'm here for one reason and one reason only. And I will tell you that reason briefly before it actually happens. But first I want to check this shit out. Oh, right. Yeah, it does change the color of the minions. That's awesome. I dig it. I love it. Now blow up. Wait, is that not the blow up? Is it dust that's the blow up? No. What's the blow up? Is it an actual special move? Oh, it's... okay, my bad. It's slash. I thought it was heavy slash. Does it blow up the... damn it. It does. I don't have the little meters over there, so yeah, it must blow those up too. I thought it just blew up the minions. Alright, well, anyway, so. Oh, right, we're here to. No, not that. Yeah, see, she's got a little bit. That's more orange. My bad, that's just regular heat. Wait, what? I thought you were supposed to release like a stream of those. What the f- Hang on. What am I missing? I'm missing something. Like, doesn't she release multiples of those? That's not considered. Zest is down D. Back D. No, those are both the command grabs. That's the little dive kick. What am I missing? I'm so confused. Like, she... Oops, no, I don't want him to display it. I thought that shot out multiples. Like, what am I missing here? I have to be missing something, right? Doesn't she shoot out multiples of them? I'm so confused. Like, I would have sworn, hang on. Oh, I get it. Okay, so it's because she has tension. And, alright. Okay, see, I'm learning. So, anyway, why are we here, Nate? We're here to see you fail at your timing. I feel like there's nobody in the world that doesn't enjoy some side boob. Am I right about that? I think I actually do like this color. Actually seeing the larger bits of it, like this footage of it, I think I dig this color. I think I'm going to use this color. Yeah, I like this color. It's pretty solid. That's sick too. I mean, come on. Who can't like that? And I mean, come on. Come on! Come on! So anyway, I still got a lot of work to do in regard to this game, obviously. In regard to any fighting game, you gotta put in time to learn it. Another thing that I actually may be considering is this dude. I just kind of discarded him because I thought he was mainly a charge character. But he only has a couple charge moves, and those charge moves are mostly useful for neutral and Oki, not really for combos. And I don't think he really has any kind of like really tight charge. So like, for instance, the biggest reason why I dropped Potemkin is because of the necessity of his hammerfall shit. I mean, not his hammerfall, his hammer break stuff. I have never been able to do it, period. Like, I'm not very good at charging in general. I'm bad at recognizing when specifically I have charge and when I don't have charge. And it varies from game to game too. Like, Street Fighter tends to have a longer time necessary for charge, whereas with this game there's really no time necessary at all between charge moves. It's like a second at most, if not even less than that in this game. This game is very fast charging. But originally I thought all of his special moves were charge moves, but it's just his I think it can actually show, like, his, so you see, you know, like just throwing the pool balls up in the air, that's not a charge move. This one is just like he just knocks a ball straight forward. This one he does like it pinballs off the top and bottom of the screen. But that's it. Those are the only, he only has two charge moves. So I might revisit Venom. Potentially, possibly. I think he's really good too. And I think in terms of aesthetics, I think he's my favorite character in this game. I'm kind of looking at the rest of the cast, trying to decide. I think I can pretty solidly say that. Yeah, I don't know. Anyway, but the biggest thing I have is... I completely forgot. I mentioned, like, right at the start of the video, I was going to talk about that Raven thing. Thank you to all of you who gave me tips, was trying to help me. I appreciate all of that, and I respect the intention behind it. But I feel it necessary to ask, how stupid do you all think I actually am? Like, that... Between when that happened and when I posted that, I mean, number one, the video wasn't even necessarily about the combo, but just between when it happened, when I got the video, when I posted the video, that I hadn't figured that out by then, that like I really thought that was a difficult combo that I was struggling with. I don't know if I should feel insulted. But so that the reason why I posted that is for those of you that paid attention to the whole Chip thing. Originally, when I dropped Chip, it was because I thought he was too executionally difficult. I thought that the threshold for his combo execution, his neutral execution, was just too high and it required more work than I was willing to put in. But then far later on down the line, that little seed of doubt was planted. And I was like, you know what? Let me revisit this. Let me just see. I've improved as a fighting game player since then. Let's see if there's any difference. And then through just the powers of muscle memory, I learned that it was not because of the combo that I was trying to do. It was his corner, B&B. The, you do, like, whatever into sweep into Rekka into his... No, it's just sweep straight into the upwards kick. Or is it Rekka into upwards kick? I'm terrible at remembering combos. Like, you put me in a situation necessary to do that combo, I'll figure it out. I'll do it, like, right away. But actually having to, like, think it through and try and talk about it, I can't do it. But anyway, the Chip's basic corner B&B, which uses the wall stick special move into jump dust, into alpha blade, wall cling, alpha blade. And so I could not get the dust into the alpha blade. It just would not combo, would not happen. I was getting the hits into alpha blade, into wall cling, into alpha blade, but they kept teching out in between. And I was like, what is wrong here? How is this timing so tight that even inputting the special move before the normal move even comes out, they still manage to tech out? What the fuck am I doing wrong? This is ridiculous. This is stupid. Why is this so hard? And then I found out it's because I wasn't hitting with dust. It's because I was pressing the wrong button. And so I thought it would be funny for me to be in the same exact situation, looking at a combo that's fairly simple, not exactly, you know, open heart surgery over here, thinking, what is going wrong? What am I fucking up? This is so strange. And the entire time, it was because I was pressing the wrong button. And that is the biggest thing I have to work on. And it's also why I have been sitting here, why I went through everybody's special attacks and basic combo trials, everybody's. So that, not because I wanted to learn all their moves, not because I wanted to learn all their combos, even though that is helpful to do, to have that knowledge of each character, just to be able to fight them properly, but so that I could look at the move list and process the information properly into knowing exactly which buttons to press. Because it's so ingrained in me. Every single other fighting game I have played, King of Fighters, Uneel, BlazBlue, Persona 4 Arena, Street Fighter, Marvel, every other fighting game has always had on stick, that I've played on stick at least, has had the weakest button as the top left button on stick. Every single one. It is not true of this one. This one, the button layout on stick, at least the arcade layout, and I try to always use like the quote-unquote right layout, so I'm not, you know, having to change my special snowflake button setup every single time I plug in my stick, and just be able to generally be able to just plug in and play. You know, it's just easier that way. So punch is bottom left, kick is top left, then slash and heavy slash both to the right of it, and then underneath heavy slash is dust. So you're kind of forming like a little bridge, like an upside down U over this whatever the circle button on a PS3, PS4 stick. It doesn't really matter. But yeah, so that's the button layout, and so it's just so ingrained in my head that, oh, the weakest button is the top left button. So for a very long time, whenever I saw punch, I just immediately hit kick, because that's how every other fighting game has been. And so that's what I've been trying to do, is get rid of that just subconscious thought of, oh, there's punch, let me hit the weak button. And I still haven't completely gotten rid of it. I still haven't completely gotten to that point where I can look at something and just be like, oh yeah, this is exactly what I need to do. I know exactly which buttons to press and I don't even have to think about it. And that's where I want to get, to the point where I can look at somebody's combo notation and just be like, all right, cool, let me translate that into these button presses super easy. I can do that in BlazBlue, I can do that in Marvel. I don't have to sit here and think about which button I'm pressing. But so far, that is where I'm at with Guilty Gear. and I need to rid myself of that. And so that's what I'm working on majorly. That's why I did all those combos. That's why I am sitting here thinking, all right, I'm willing to go through mission mode, not because I think it's completely necessary, because a lot of the basic mission mode stuff is all just like basics of fighting games, which while I may not have mastered, these are basically just introducing you to the concepts. I understand the concepts. I know the concepts. But just being able to do this and work on doing different things, work on understanding various button stuff is very important, obviously, so that I can actually translate that into just being able to do it and not having to think about it. That's the biggest thing. You should not, during any match, if you are actively sitting back and thinking about what you are doing, you're doing it wrong. You're playing too slow. You cannot give yourself time to think about your every little action. It just has to be something that, like, you know, you have to be a computer. You have to gather all of the necessary information, process it all, determine which option that you have available to you is the best for that specific moment based upon your knowledge of opponent tendencies and all that stuff, and then execute that proper option all in the space of like 15 milliseconds. It just has to happen. You're not sitting here actually thinking, all right, I think this person is going to get hit by an overhead. Let me do an overhead. And then you do an overhead. You just do it. It just happens. And right now, I'm not in that place with this game. And that's where I need to be before I will consider myself, quote unquote, match ready. And then, you know, beyond that, obviously, is just actually learning a specific character. Like I said, I have not learned any real Jacko combos. Jacko was the first character I checked out in this list, and I can't even remember where I got to. I did one whole combo with Jacko out of the basic stuff, but yeah. One, actually, you know what? I have not watched this item. Oh, that's right, because actually, let me go back real quick. I remember why I stopped now. Do you see that? The third and fourth inputs. Forward heavy slash into a jump cancel into an air dash. That's an instant air dash. That's why I stopped. I remember now. I'm terrible. I'm good at instant air dashing from the left side. I mean, not from the second player side, from the right side. I'm good at instant air dashing on that side. I'm good at basically everything on that side. But movement to the right, I need to work on. I'm not quite so fast. I'm not quite as good at it. So, like, for instance, you see, like, I didn't even try to instant air dash. So I got one. Actually, I guess really. Once I actually get the timing down so it's not eating my jump command when I land. But you can see I'm fairly I'm not 100%, but I'm fair, which I should be. And that speaks toward a weakness in my abilities as a fighting game player. That's something that a more dedicated individual would sit down and grind out, and so they're getting that 100% of the time. I'm not dedicated. But then you look at, like, this one, I'm terrible on this side. I'm, like, maybe 50% if I'm lucky. And actually, this, I really like this thing in the middle that actually shows your input specifically, because I don't have to, like, glance over. I don't have to try and not pay attention to the action and look at the very edge, the right edge of the screen in order to see stuff that's happening. I can just look at my inputs and see exactly what I'm doing. So you'll see, when I'm trying to do up forward, I basically never actually get straight up forward. I'm going, like, over here first, because right there, I'm about halfway in between up and forward. And so, like, you really have to hit the corner in order to actually get that up forward. And so you're, like, I'm only trying to hit that up forward. I'm not trying to do anything else. And you see, I am getting mostly, like, quarter circles over there. More so than I'm actually getting just the straight up forward. And so that really, that obviously speaks toward a weakness in my execution that needs to be fixed if I want to be a high-level player. Granted, at the moment, I don't really care about being a high-level player, but it's still something that is the biggest reason why I'm not that good at instant air dashes, is because I don't just go straight up, back to neutral, straight over there. I'm going fucking wildly doing my Tager 360s and just hoping I get an instant air dash. But so anyway, let me check out this sample real quick, because I didn't look at the best combo. See, I like these kinds of combos. That, obviously, it's possible for them to happen, because you're literally setting the little houses in between. So that's going to happen every single time. At least I assume. I assume they have the same spawning rate based upon when they're placed, rather than being based on, like, just a universal timer that activates at the start of the match or something. It would be far more intelligent design to base it upon when they're placed, rather than, like, any other kind of thing. I forgot. Do I just press down on the button? Oh, I press down and punch? Oh, no, that just grabs it. I can't remember. Oh, do I just press down on the button again? No. I can't remember how to re-grab. Obviously, like I said, I got a lot of work to do, because I did Jacko's stuff first, and then immediately hopped into the tutorial, started to do missions, started to do everybody else's stuff, so I've basically forgotten 90% of what I did. Down plus P. Oh, my bad, that was pickup. I don't want to pick it up. I want to... Oh, while you're holding it. Oops, my bad. God damn, see, I'm pressing kick again. Okay, that makes sense. Oh, can you? Does it spawn? So let me look. There's a pretty... Unless there's a limit on how many can be out at any given time. Maybe based on level? Oh, did one of them disappear? Oh, they disappear after a time. So there's probably a limit of 2 per. Makes sense. You know, you wouldn't want to just let Jacko turtle up and swarm the screen with like 5,000 of these dudes. Okay, so there is 1 per. But let me just... What did I want to... Yeah, so it seems pretty universal in terms of the timing. Yo, their weapons get better based upon the level? Like, at level 2, they had a little just regular kind of lance going on. Now these dudes got a trident? Damn, I like it. I really like Jacko's flavor. I really do. Like, I'm concerned about the depth of the character overall and whether or not that will hold up to and keep me interested in playing the character. God damn it. Yeah, it seems like and they don't go away. Yeah, it just... I mean, obviously, I assume it won't if there's 2 already out. So yeah, once you set... The moment you set it... Damn, and they get massive broadsword-looking things! What are the... Oh, my bad, that's the wrong button. What do the slash dudes get? Now I gotta see this. Okay, so they have staves. Staves? Whatever. So what do they get when they level up? Is there really... I don't really see a difference in terms of the arc. Oh, they rebound off the wall. I'll have to keep that in mind, because that could impact trajectory. Oh, yeah, look. They got bigger staves, and they're kind of bell-ended, I guess. That dude up top is confused as fuck. He can't make a decision on which side he wants to be on. Oh, that's sick. They get, like, giant stars. That's kind of... Oh, maybe they have to, like, be in the air in order to, that doesn't work. What's the one that combos off of that? Is it back? Oops, my bad. It would help if I was pressing the right button. That didn't work. That one works. Okay, and then you poop them out and stuff happens. All right. Because I think that's her main combo ender that you want to use, is knockdown into that, into the little grab thing. But I know, like, that is her... This is her main neutral tool. This is basically everything you want to use in her neutral, and then there's that as well. Like, those two buttons are the entirety of her neutral. And she does... Ah, that actually looks pretty good. Doing the cha-cha? I can do the cha-cha. Oh, right, because down. That functions as her sweep. Her down plus dust, I believe that's an invincible reversal. I'm not sure if it's fully invincible or if it's vulnerable to anything. And she has to be able to combo off that. Like, come on. What's the good? Is it forward heavy slash? Yeah. Damn it, stop getting hit. No, I guess not. Obviously, if you RC it, it'll work. Alright, anyway, I'm not here to learn this character. Damn, I didn't even realize it's been 15 minutes. I glanced over at 30 minutes to talk about, like, the one last thing, and it's been 15 minutes since then. My bad. I am interested right now. I am invested right now, and that's a good thing. It's a feeling I never really got when playing Sign. I got it very briefly when I started to learn Chip, and then I got into actual matches, and I fought an Elfelt, and I felt her damage. And then after fighting that Elfelt and feeling the depth of her damage to my very inside of my very soul, I then fought a Slayer. And that was even worse. Not in terms of like a difficulty standpoint, but when Slayer hits you right, he hits you hard. And I think it was like I was actually perfecting this player at the moment, which is like a huge achievement for me at the moment to have everything fall together with Chip properly to be able to be running a perfect on somebody after a decent amount of time. And then he hit me once, corner carried me, and then I got hit by a mix-up in the corner and died from just those two hits. And then at that point I was like, okay, shit. That's what playing this character is like. Oh dear God, I don't know if I can do this. But like I said, it's good that I'm feeling at least something right now. So, anyway, I got shit to work on, and I gotta get to work! So, thank you for watching, and hopefully everything comes together, and I can become the best Jacko player in the world, as is my birthright!